Good day, everyone. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Grant Tuhon, Leo T. Gahe Jr. I am the Supreme Grandmaster of the Piggy Theater College System. Allow me to introduce my good friend, Jason Bird. He's instrumental in this interview. The information of everybody, I am the Lieutenant Colonel of the Philippine Army, Armed Forces of the Philippines. And I would like to magnify the importance of our system as applied to the military and law enforcement in our country, the Philippines, and other countries of the world. Piggy Tertia is a system that has been there since 1897. Today is 2013. Between 1897 and 2013, many things had happened to Piggy Tertia. First of all, the history of Piggy Tertia is a very unique history because it deals a lot of activities and memories that if I ever tell everybody, it will take 365 this year. I am 75 years old. My heart is pure. Meaning, I could explain in details regarding the components of Piggy Tertia. But first of all, in 1972, when I started this discipline in the state of New York, especially in the Great Apple, which is New York City, it was the time that the popularity of other martial arts like karate, judo, aikido, jiu-jitsu, and all other Chinese martial arts had dominantly controlled the industry. Seeing that there was no Filipino fighting system or martial arts in New York City, particularly in the East Coast and the Midwest, I decided that I have to open the avenues of understanding that in the world of martial arts, it's not only the empty hands that becomes the dominant factor in survival, but the most important is the understanding the elements of blade culture. Blade culture signifies the Philippines as a country because we had dealt our enemies for three historical events. Number one, we fought against the 333 years colonization of the Spanish government in the Philippines. And secondly, the American presence from 1907 to 1920. And thirdly, the Japanese invasion of 1940 to 1945. These three major events, on record, the Philippines won against the 333 years, against the 1907, 1920, and against 1940 to 1945. Evidence by that history is the fact that the colonization of the Philippines for 333 years, revolution against the Spaniards by the Filipinos contemporaneos, made history of the Philippines very significant. Because in spite of the religious influences among the Filipinos, the dissatisfactions against the religious influences had reached to the point of rebellion. It was rebellion because there was so much abuses of the Spanish people and the Spanish soldiers against the Filipinos. For that reason, the rise of blade culture became a dominant factor in everyday life of each Filipinos. The Filipinos bond themselves together in order to fight against the terroristic activities and intrusion of the family unit within the families of Filipinos. And in the 7,100 islands, the presence of Spanish atrocities had been experienced because the friars, the priests, were instrumental in these atrocities. I remember when I was young, I studied in a university. This university is run by priests, and these friars are wearing belts, leather belts, that we kids, if we commit a mistake, they hit us with their belts, which is very painful because it was a thick belt used by the friars. That meant there was dominance against us who are young people who want to learn, because they want to inject to us this Spanish education. So it was not only with the kids, but also with the adults. And the abuses went to the extreme that the Spanish soldiers had to take the daughters of the family. The wives that are beautiful, they are taking them. And also the abuses of the priest. It is on record that there was a rampant abuses of the Spanish presence in the Philippines. But it was unfortunate because the Spanish regime did not realize that the Filipino fighting culture has been kept secret. And this fighting culture was called Kali. A Kali was a philosophy of the early Filipinos. The components of this Kali doctrine is to believe in life, not to believe in death. To believe in success, not to believe in failures. To believe in good health, not to believe in sickness. With these principles around this doctrine, which is the Kali doctrine, a Kali principles of discipline, a doctrine by itself, has been the guiding star of the revolution. Every Filipinos that fought against the bad influences of the Spanish press in the Philippines was countered by the Kali philosophy. Kali is a language which is related to Indian belief or Indian doctrine. Because for 800 years, under the influence of Hindu religion, the Filipinos had enjoyed that presence of Hinduistic practices, which is more on a passive diplomatic character of people. We are very soft people during those days. We didn't have violence. We were very respectful, and we exercised that culture, traditions and customs. The influence was so strong that it developed a character that demands respect, a character that demands concern and care, and a character that is hospitalistic. We are very hospitable people. There was no sign of violence, there was no practice of violence. But Kali as a doctrine is for peace and harmony. The practices, as far as the utilization of Kali principle, has been brought into the blade culture. There is a blade culture, there is a blade that is symbolic as far as Kali is concerned. We have the Kali blades, we have the Kali knives, and we have the Kali weapons as a form of protection. Other weapons are used for hunting purposes, but under the Kali doctrine, the Kali blades were kept as a reserve for any eventuality. Since we believe in life, we have to protect this life. Since we protect this life, we have to be successful in utilizing this weapon against the enemy. And because of that success, we have to be in good health in order that we can sustain the enemy fighting by the hours, by the days, and by the years. 333 years, my friends, of sustaining the Filipino image and the Filipino bravery. We save a lot of lives using the Kali doctrine. We saved the whole country for 333 years. Kali was so strong that the Spanish government gave up their presence in the Philippines. And under the Treaty of Paris of 1898, they sold us to the Americans at the Treaty of Paris. $3 per head or $20 billion. We are the cheapest commodity, cheaper than Manhattan, New York City. Kali was a strong foundation over the Filipino culture. A culture that was very, very strong. We stood against all odds. The Filipino families stood side by side against the Spanish atrocities. So the foundation of this fighting system has been there for a long, long time. Comes that time when the Americans went to the Philippines to acquire the Philippines the fact that they have bought the country from Spain at $3 per head or $20 million. So the first expedition was sent to the Philippines was under Admiral Dewey. And Admiral Dewey and his sailors came down from the ship and they were met by the Filipinos. And right then and then they were given a welcome with spears and blades and kinomtings. That the fight was on. But Admiral Dewey was not good in the land and his soldiers because they were Navy. They are good in the sea. And the story was the United States government was not happy about the expedition and instead Admiral Dewey requests for the presence of the infantrymen under Black Jack Pershing with his special units coming from Cuba. They called the Blue Search or the South Dakota Brigade. They came down to the Philippines and tried to confront the Filipinos in the fort against the Filipino blades, against the 38 revolver and the Kruger rifles. But right then, there was a manifestation of bravery and courage among the Filipinos that the charge against the American soldiers with their 38 revolver and Kruger rifles, and they were able to cut them in close quarter using the ginunting, the talibongs, the parang, and all kinds of weapons that the Filipinos were prepared. The fight was tremendous. There was a defeat within the Americans because they could not stand the slashes and the thrashes, that the blood was all over the place. They were demoralized. Admiral Dewey and Black Jack Pershing requested for a weapon that could stop the Filipinos, and a 45 caliber was developed against these Filipinos. A 45 caliber pistol was developed against the Kali discipline. That went on until the time that the Americans' presence in the Philippines was an encouragement for the Americans to give the Filipinos a commonwealth. To save the Americans' presence in the Philippines, that they will not be defeated in the Philippines, they give the Philippines the commonwealth, meaning a part of the United States. Well, Spain showed us to the Americans because that was an indication that they were about to be defeated by the Filipinos. So they want to save their faces all over the world by selling us to the Americans in the Treaty of Paris of 1898. And the Americans give us the Commonwealth. And the Commonwealth give us a presence of joint partnership or bring the Filipinos to the armed forces of the United States as part of the soldiers, as part of the American military presence in the Philippines. There was a good relationship between the Americans and the Filipinos until in 1942 the Japanese came to the country. Americans and Filipino soldiers were about 20,000. And the Japanese came in with 200,000, including their air force, their navy, and their soldiers. Of course, there was war going on in the Pacific, but the Philippines was one of the targets. So the presence of the Japanese in the Philippines in 1942, the invasion of the Japanese in the Philippines in 1942, was a kind of battle that, as far as the record of the Second World War is concerned, Philippines and Japanese fighting each other was tremendously filled with blood. The Americans who were there in the Philippines surrendered to the Japanese, and General Wainwright surrendered to the Japanese, but the Filipinos did not surrender. Filipinos went back to the mountain and sharpened the bolos, and they did some surprise attacks against the Japanese patrols. General MacArthur fled from his country, went back by Australia, and went back to the United States. For 2 years, the Americans left us against the Japanese. We fought against the Japanese for 2 years. We fought the guerrilla tactics, meaning hit and run. And because of that, the Japanese, not to accept defeat, they fled from the country, bringing all their weapons that they can bring, including their tanks, including their ships. And they fled from the Philippines, drove by the Filipino bravery and courage. And while they're on their way back to Japan, they were met by General MacArthur's heavy armed forces, which is the Air Force, the Navy, right into the Philippine Sea. And it was recorded in history as the famous Battle of the Philippine Sea. The convoy that was supposed to go to Japan was stopped right there in the international water. And that was the very reason why Japan, as a part of the surrender, lost its main forces in the Pacific. This history, my friends, proved that the Filipino fighting system has been a sustaining factor against these three major activities in the Philippines 333 years, 1907 to 1920, 1940 to 1945. The art that you are learning, which is the Piketty-Tersch system, has been one of the moving systems in the revolution. My forefathers and the great forefathers and fathers were once involved on those great part of the war, the revolution. The technology of the system and other systems that were used against the Japanese, against the Spaniards, against the Americans, were all perfected in forms of laboratory testing. Every family that were warlike had been encouraged to develop their systems, and these systems has been there for a long time. That every technique that they have utilized during the war, during the encounter and close quarter, has been perfected, and it costs lots of lives to perfect one technique. So Piketty-Tersch and other systems that were real, that has not been polluted by the Japanese martial arts, those systems that are pure Kali system, became a secret, and every family that had the secret or the system, they didn't want to teach. And Piketty-Tersch is one of the systems that had been kept there for a while, And while I was with my grandfather in Negros Occidental, in the town of Mission, just after the war, Piggy Tertia has been kept by my grandfather, and he was the only one among the other brothers that maintained the technology, and this technology had been kept. And I was privileged to be trained when I was 6 years old. And it was a real opportunity for me to learn, because it was a discipline with an instruction that he told me, I train you not to teach, but I train you to protect the property and to protect the property. And in 1972, I violated that order. And 2 years, I was not able to my uncle, the brother of my grandfather, when he was in Illinois. But I asked forgiveness. I explained that it is about time that we have to come out, because we don't want that the Filipino culture, which is the Blake culture, will be bastardized by people who are teaching the impurities of the Filipino fighting system. Because there are people who are trying to blend the Blake culture with the Japanese culture. At one in the hell, we're going to blend with the Japanese, when the Japanese were using atrocities and killed a lot of Filipinos. And we still love to embrace the Japanese culture. To me, that is not reasonable for us to make our system impure by bringing the other discipline to the purities, or to mix to the purities of the Filipino fighting system, which is the art of Kali. So, we believe that we have to carry on the purity of the Filipino discipline, the Filipino cultural discipline, the culture and the traditions and the customs, and more, indeed, the ideology of the system. Because the true Filipino culture is based on the Blake culture that contributes to bravery and courage. We who are now the generations of the true Filipino culture, which is the Piggy Tertia Kala system, has been instrumental in bringing the edge weapon back to life. It was in the year of 80s that I brought up the edge program into the criminal justice system and to different law enforcement agencies in the country. And it was welcome that the first number one training videos, Surviving Edge Weapon, became popular, distributed all over the world, which is shown the Piggy Tertia as a major mover in the development and the presentation as far as the Blake culture is concerned. Today, Piggy Tertia has been spreading like wildfire. We are in the armed forces of the Philippines. We are in the armed forces of India. We are in the Austrian Cobra Commandos and Austrian Jaguar Commando. We are also in the armed forces of the Philippines, the Special Forces. And we are also in the criminal justice system. And we are also playing an important program with different intelligence agencies in many countries of the world. The purpose of bringing the Piggy Tertia into the military is to assist the military in its fighting program against the enemy. The war that was Second World War was not as dangerous as the war of today, because the war of yesterday was not based on terrorism. But today, the war is a war on terror. Meaning to say that the enemy that you are supposed to fight is not seen by battalions or brigades or division or company or platoon. The enemies that we are fighting is within the crowd of people. They cause havoc, they cause massacre, they cause bombing, they cause a lot of killing, which is very difficult to fight. So the edge weapon is one of the solutions. That solutions is brought back to the blade culture. Meaning to say that if a soldier is trained in the blade culture, he triples his fighting spirit and he is more confident that during the time of the close quarter encounter, he can survive by all means. Our training is hard and tedious. Our training is, we call it 8 days a week. Our training is one of the hardest training in military. In the Philippines, the first group of soldiers that we trained were the Force Recon Marines, the elite forces of the Philippine Marines or the Armed Forces of the Philippines. They have trained and utilized the Pigito system against their campaign in Mindanao against the Al-Qaeda's, against the Islamic terror. And in the part of the Philippines, they use it against the New People's Army. Pigitertia is right tested in the field, and it works, and it still continued to work. As a matter of fact, the Philippine Army, this counter-ranger, has been trained thoroughly, diligently, in the art of Pigitertia. They use Pigitertia as their secondary line of defense. The Special Action Force Commandos of the Philippine National Police. Other agencies of the government had been very lucky to have the participation of the training program of Pigitertia color system. It was an opportunity that our blade culture became a part of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Because when a soldier take hold of the blade, take hold of the ginunting, all the spirits of their forefathers were in rejoice because they were happy that we revived the technology that won against the Spaniards, won against the Americans, and won against the Spaniards. Pigitertia system is a very unique system because it has the foundation which is very strong. The foundation laid out in forms of system by system. The methodology distributed into a very systematic procedures that for a student to learn, it takes patience, it takes endurance, it takes kind of courage, and it takes kind of decision. When I started in New York, there are only two students. Later on, we have 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7. Now we got many, many students in many parts of the world. There is a saying, somebody has to lead for others to follow. And we are the leaders in terms of the Edge Weapon program. I was the one responsible in bringing the life of the Edge Weapon into the military and into the law enforcement. And today, 2013, Pigitertia will live as strong for the next 100 years. Many countries in the world are demanding to have a program on Edge Weapon program. Because as I said, the world today is not fighting against the presence of the enemy by battalion, by brigade, or by division. The enemy that we don't know and we don't see is the enemy that we have to meet along the way. And the only solution is not by the guns, it is by the edge weapon. The danger is present every day. And the Philippines today is one of the countries in Asia that had experienced a lot of killing. And last May 13, which was yesterday, there was an election, national elections in the Philippines, from senators down to governor, down to congressmen, down to different, you know, councils of different municipalities. And on record, the news gave us update on how many people were killed by ambush, by hacking, by knifing, and shooting at the same time. The answer is, for a country to survive, there must be a revelation, or there must be a revival of a true blade culture. Because by practicing the blade culture, it reduces the possibility of assault or attack by enemy, because they know that they could be cut when they ever attempt to use their weaponry, especially the guns, against the blade. Because the beauty in having the blade culture is you are expert in the elements of surprises. You are expert in the in means of survival, and you are expert in the way you fight, because you are so clever and so smart that you don't want to be taken advantage. If the guy has a gun, you don't face him with a gun. You use your strategy not to be hit by the gun, or not to be seen by the guy who is using the gun. Today, the experiences of our instructors and our people that have studied Pigitertia is quite unique and so historical that if everyone will have to tell the stories, it will not fill the book as far as history is concerned. Pigitertia will live forever, and Pigitertia will be the strongest system when we call it as a martial arts. Pigitertia, as a philosophy based on the Kali doctrine, and Pigitertia as a discipline, is a cultural discipline. And Pigitertia as a doctrine will never die. It will live forever. Let me talk about now what are the components of the Pigitertia. Pigitertia basically has its own foundation, which is the basic 12 methods, or the 12 methods. And this 12 methods is a highly fundamental principles within the system. Because here you are taught the principles of the basic abecedario, down to 64 attacks, down to the contradas, down to the signatures. And all these are a movement that is a flowing movement that will generate a good motion and action, movements or per movements, and strategic footwork and tactical application, so that when you go higher into the higher part of the system, the foundation is so important and strong. There is no question when a person develops himself under the 12 methods. As a matter of fact, that is an advantage for one who learned that. And the second part is the tribe formula. We call it Tatlong Palapag in Filipino. The tribe formula is based on Puntadas, Panapos, Puntadas, Panapos, Panapas. The three P's of Pigitertia: Puntadas, Panapos, and of course, the one that provides the tribe formula for the three section of the system. The Panapos, Puntadas are the most important. The Panabas, Puntadas, Panapos. Panapos means to finish, Puntadas means the thrust, Panabas means the slash. So if you have this weapon, you have the slash, you have the thrust, and you have the finishing, which is the Panapos. That means that under the tribe formula, it has its important role in terms of combat. Tribe formula is a triangle, and a triangle has a specific description, which is three sides are equal. A complete substance of a triangle is perfect. Perfect in the sense that the person could be diagnosed under the principle of a triangle. Whatever he does, whatever his movement, he is always within the premise of a triangle. He is within the substance of a triangle. So person to person, me as a triangulated person, looking at another person and the principles of triangle, I have a complete diagnosis of a person's movement, because since he is a triangle, I could imbalance him by using the principles of destroying a part of the triangle, which is one side of the triangle will imbalance the rest of the triangle. Since the three sides are equal, I will unequalize one side so that I can destroy the triangle. But in our case, since we have the tribic formula, we don't want to be destroyed. Since we have the formula, our formula is perfect. We have the triangle, we have the square, and we have the circle. All these three are perfect in its components. There is no imperfection in our system. We deal with the doctrine of discipline, and we deal with the doctrine of perfection. When we deliver the slash, when we deliver the thrust, it has to be perfect. Because if I aim to decapitate and take your head off, I want to be sure that my slash is perfect. When I deliver a thrust, when I want to take half of your body in perfect delivery, I could separate your right arm, your right side of the body to the left side, and I see to it that I cut you in between your eyes. That is perfection in a right application. When I want to deliver and cut your knee, I see to it that that is perfect slash, perfect diagonal slash. When I see to it that I will return to the left knee, I see to it that that is perfect. In other words, I could remove major parts of your body within 3 seconds, because in triangulations or in tribi formula, we hit only three and they move you everything. We don't want to have so many cuts. We will only deliver 3 cuts in 3 seconds. So my friends, what you're learning here is not a mixed martial arts. What you're learning here is a system, pure and simple, effective and deadly. That is what the military wants. That is what everyone wants. Why do you have to waste your time spending training or going into a school of martial arts, and you will be stuck on the street and you will be hacked right in the place where you belong? Even you are going home, you'll be ambushed. When you're on the road, you'll hear your car be hit by another car, and somebody goes down in his car and he takes a baseball bat and slam you into the mirror and kill you. Today, life is precious. Precious as diamond, precious as gold. You don't want to gamble your life to be taken away by somebody who is stupid. A person that is drunk, a person that is problematic, will take your life away. The purpose of this life is to be protected, and it is your responsibility to protect your life. If you don't protect your life, you are charged with negligence, which is one of the criminal acts of a human person, negligent to protect his life. And if you allow the criminal to exist within your vicinity, try to rape your wife, try to kill your daughter, try to abduct your son, would you allow that to happen? If you allow that to happen, then you are a person liable for a certain commitment, which is to protect your family. You are a person affected or a part of that act by the criminal to take advantage of your family. So we don't want this to happen. So Piggy the Tertia is a reminder to everyone that each person has his own responsibility. That is what Piggy the Tertia is for. To protect you, to protect your family, to protect your property. Today and the next tomorrow, be sure that you have this doctrine. We are not encouraging you, but we want you to be part of the Pigeter Shakali system. We always say, somebody has to lead for others to follow. We are the leaders in this important discipline. We don't call it martial arts. We don't call it martial arts. We call it cultural discipline. Because once you study with us, we culture you, little by little, until the time that we see that we can release you from the bondage of our discipline, because you want to be free. But when you go back to your teachings based on the tribal formula, you will be able to open your mind to say that the formula is going to work, because I will formulate my technique, formulate my actions, formulate my decisions on how to eliminate the enemy without a waste of time. Pigetertia, my friend, is an institution. It's an institution without walls. It is an institution where the art of common sense is the most effective way to learn. When somebody learns from me, and then somebody learns from, try to teach to somebody, there is what we call a continuity of education. You teach how to learn, and you learn how to teach. So the education will go on and go on and go on. We bring the school to you and to your friends. You don't need to have a sophisticated building to learn. You don't have to need a sophisticated playground or sophistication of places with an air-conditioned room and all of this. We train outside. We have an environment. An environment where you're going to meet your enemy. An environment that you will be facing your enemy that you don't know and you don't see. Pigetertia. It's a structure. It is a structure designed geometrically. Because when you know your geometrical equation, then you can meet the enemy, regardless what kind of style he does, what kind of system he has. It will always be answered by the perfect science. Because we deal with the perfect science. We deal with mathematics. We deal with geometrics. We deal with logarithms. We deal with trigonometry. We deal with physics. And that is very important. So, since Pigetertia is an institution, it is not a high school, it is a college, and it is a university. When you talk about it, it is an education of the world. Because the world today demands that you have to learn security and protection. You can be a banker, you can be a multimillionaire, you can be a famous businessman, but you lack that important substance in life. Security, my friends. You want to live longer? Secure your life. You want to live longer? You have to believe in good health. You want to live longer? You have to believe in success. You want to live longer? You have to believe in life. These are the three philosophies, philosophical components of Pigetertia. Many who had been under my program for a long time, for the last 40, 45 years, they had made confession that because they were able to absorb the philosophy of Pigetertia, they were able to save their life against certain conditions that they had experienced. From the Midwest to the East Coast to the West Coast to the North America and to other parts in Asia. They say, Tuhan, your explanation, your doctrine, although we have not engaged with you personally in terms of training, but reading all the materials that you have in the Facebook help us to understand that we have a responsibility as a person. And that's what we want today. We want everybody to be responsible to yourselves, to be responsible to save your family and to your loved ones and to your property. There's no other responsibilities that you would exercise, except you want to protect your country, then we have to be together to defend the country against terrorism. Pigetertia will be in your blood. Because when we found that your bloodline blends with our bloodline, then we talk with the same language. We talk with the same kind of food that we have to eat. We talk the same pleasure that we would like to enjoy. We will be the same all the rest of our lives. There will be no difference, there will be no indifference, because we love each other. The only discipline that loves his enemy is Pikitatosya. We love our enemy, because if you don't love your enemy, then you will see an enemy and the enemy will be away from you. But if you show love to your enemy, then he will be on your hand. You can embrace him and kill him right there. You can kiss him with a kiss of death. You can sleep with him and stab him while he's sleeping, because he's a traitor. But you show him love. Do not show him hate. We don't hate our enemy. We love our enemy. Because the more you hate, the more you love. Pikitatosya, my friends, is the art of treachery. Pikitatosya is the art that very hard to learn, but easy to work with it. Pikitatosya will be yours forever. Never leave home without it. The instrument of peace, will be your savior. This is the instrument of peace, my friend. When there was revolution in heaven, that famous history of San Miguel, he uses the blade. When there was revolution in heaven. When the revolution went down to earth, the Israelites were fighting with blades. The Canaanites, the Mesopotamites, the enemy went on so far. The history of the Bible tells us that there was war. The world was created with war. How many people died under the blessings of the blade? You talk about the Roman Empire, you talk about Genghis Khan, you talk about the Knights of Templars, you talk about the Dark Ages, you talk about the Huguenot War, you talk about Hannibal, the Huns, you talk about the First World War, you talk about the Second World War, the Third World War is coming. The blade, my friends. Sleep with it, don't live with home without it. It will save your life. That's Pikitatosya. We see you next time. Be around. Good luck.